Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. People are asking, what should we do now that the ceasefire has been put in place? First of all, this issue does not stop by ceasefire. Ceasefire after ceasefire, but continuation of this ethnic cleansing by this apartheid system will go on and on until this apartheid system comes to an end. And for that, we need to demonstrate, we need to lobby, we need to boycott, we need to raise funds to help the victims, and all that information is available on our website. And I urge you to do that all the time. I urge you also to look at this clip that you're going to see, which is a colleague of mine, that after 2008 war, he was sent part of a team and his experience when he went to Gaza. Please continuously support the people in Palestine.
Another protest, another demonstration. Palestine is on the news yet again. And you and I are being asked to go and stand outside with placards outside Downing Street, appealing to a government that really doesn't care about the Palestinian people. So why are we doing it? Why are we being asked to do it? What benefit will it bring? I had these same thoughts many years ago, and I stopped going to demonstrations until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me on a unique journey to find the answer to that very question. I received a call from the Islamic Human Rights Commission who wanted me to travel to Gaza to document the atrocities. On arrival, we were greeted and welcomed, and it was embarrassing. Wallahi, they were treating us like heroes. We did nothing, and yet these are the people who are giving us dates, they're giving us fruit, they're giving us water, they're praising us, and they were thanking us for our bravery and our courage, and we couldn't understand, because if anyone was being brave and courageous, it was them. And what they said to us was, every time we felt despondent, every time we felt the Israeli aggression was too much, that we felt we can't carry on seeing our children dying this way, every time we thought, how can we go on against this superpower, we turned on our TV stations, we turned on our radios, we heard the reports, we saw the footage of Muslims across the world in their thousands marching on the streets. And they specifically said, we saw you people in London standing on the streets, marching, protesting, clashing, doing whatever you could to be at one with the Palestinian people. And you know, brothers and sisters, I felt like zero at that time. I felt, subhanAllah, that I didn't even attend one demonstration. And I thought, look at how Allah sent me all the way to the Holy Land, only for the brothers there to tell me, go back to London and get on the streets. My brothers and sisters, going onto the streets and protesting may not change the government policy. What it definitely will do, and this is coming from the mouth of the Palestinian people themselves, it will show them solidarity. It will show them that they are not alone. The words of the brothers echo in my head right now. He says, you showed us that the Ummah is behind us and that we are not doing this for the Palestinians. We are doing this for the Ummah. So we carried on resisting.